Hey guys, so I'm coming at you all with a makeup look. I'm not necessarily sure how it's gonna turn out. I just wanted to do something because I haven't recorded my makeup in a little while. But first off, you see I have this thing covering my hair. Yes, I still have the 613 hair that I colored. This is called the Turby Twist, the Turby Band Twist. And this is basically gonna help my hair from getting in the way of doing my makeup. I got this from Octali, so thank you Octali. And basically I decided to review this because I needed something to keep my hair out the way as I apply my makeup, because you know I have a frontal in right now and I'm really cautious of how I apply my makeup when it comes to getting into my hairline, since I do have the Got To Be Ultra Glue Gel. So I figured that this was gonna be a great alternative. All I needed to do was literally just slide it under my neck and then slide it over my head, and it just literally pulls like this, so I'll be able to put my hair in a ponytail, so it's just literally out the way. You can use this basically to apply makeup, to remove it, wash your face, all of that good stuff. So yeah, it says just slide your head through the Turby band, pull the Turby band up over your face and tuck the hair inside, and you're ready to go. I didn't tuck my hair inside because I'm not, you know, getting in the shower or anything. So yeah, so without further ado, I've already done my eyebrows for you know, the sake of the video, but I am gonna go into my Benefit Gimme Brow, because this is like an awesome brow product just to, you know, finish up your brows, just in case, you know you need the little finishing touch. So I'll just do that and just brush through my brows. Okay, so I'm using tape on my eyes just because I want a very crisp and clean look with this eyeshadow look. So the first palette I'm going to be using for the eyeshadow is my Master Mario palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I'm also going to use the brush that came inside of the palette just because I like the fluffy side. It does its job. I'm going to use the color Isabel, which is this really peachy tone color right here, and this is going to be my transition color. And you know something, I did not even prime my eyes, crazy me. So I'm going to go in and prime my eyes with my LA Girl Pro Concealer in Pure Beige. My eyes are primed, and like I said, I'm gonna go into the color Isabel out of the Master Mario palette from Anastasia, and I'm just gonna use that as my transition shade. I'm gonna go into the Modern Renaissance palette, and I'm gonna use the color Real Gar with this Ofra 21 brush, and I'm just gonna put that literally right on top of Isabel. Out of the Modern Renaissance palette, I'm gonna use the color Red Ochre. Right before my camera really started to die on me, so irritating, I am taking a Red Ochre out of the Modern Renaissance palette. Honestly, with all these colors put on top of each other, they really kind of look the same. That's okay, I'm gonna go in and add some dimension. Did I tell you guys it's gonna be kind of like a cut crease, glitter cut crease type of thing? If I didn't, you know now. So I've added that, and really it all looks like one color. But I'm gonna go into Cypress Umber, which is the dark brown color inside of the Modern Renaissance palette, and I'm just gonna use this little stiff definer brush, and I'm gonna put that all in my crease. Next, with this eyeshadow brush that came in my Urban Decay Naked palette and my Pure Beige concealer. I'm just going to dip in this side and I'm going to begin to carve out the space where I don't want all of this color at. Next, I'm going to take this ColourPop shadow in the color Shock, and this is a matte color, and I'm going to put this all over my lid. I'm just going to assume it was just meant for it to be like this. I look kind of crazy right now just because the eye makeup isn't finished in its entirety. However, I'm going to add my winged eyeliner because that's a plus, a must actually, if I can find it. Now I'm going to take my Dodo lashes in the Style D305 and I'm just going to apply them with my Ardell lash glue. Okay, so now that my lashes are on, I'm going to go in with my LA Colors Jumbo White Eyeliner Pencil and I'm just going to line my waterline. My skin with the Maybelline Baby Skin Primer and the Becca Evermatte Poreless Perfecting Primer, so I don't, you know, need to go back over that. But I am going to be using my Maybelline Fit Me Foundation in the color 355 Coconut. This is a very, very, very red shade for me, but however, this is the only drugstore foundation I really like so far. I have been using the Anastasia foundation stick in the color Cool Golden. However, I mean, it's perfect shade for me, as you can see. It's really nice, but it's just, I just don't really care for how it makes me. Well, it says it's for normal oily skin. I have oily skin, normal to oily skin. However, it just cakes up around my nose after a while. Like after I get sweaty and oily, it just starts caking up and then it transfers super easily, like ugh. But I'm still use it because I paid $25 for it. So there's no getting around that. But I am gonna mix my Maybelline. I'm just gonna dab that just to make it a little easier to blend. Like to start up the process by using my fingers because it does help blend it in a lot better. Thank you. concealer in Cool Tan to highlight under my eyes, nose, cupid's bow, chin, and forehead. If I can get it out, Jesus. Black Radiance Pressed Powder in the color Rich Mahogany. And I find that contouring with my powder works a lot more effectively when I do it before I start baking under my eyes, just because I think it just blends a little more seamlessly, I should say. Baking, and to get rid of the powdery look, I'm gonna spray my face with the Mario Badescu skincare. This is the facial spray with aloe herbs and rose water. I'm now gonna line under my eyes with Real Gar and Cypress Umber. Bottom lashes with the It Cosmetics Superhero Mascara. Now I'm going to use my ColourPop blush with my Rue and Lange Makeup Blush Brush in the color Swift. I'm going to use ColourPop and Karrueche's collaboration, which is now unavailable on ColourPop. This is the color Glow Up, and I'm going to use this as my highlight, but this isn't going to be my only highlight. This is just going to be the cream base. Ultimate Glow Kit by Anastasia, and I'm going to use the color Rose Gold. Don't you cry, baby. Away. sorry guys, I just used this NK brown eyeliner as lip liner in Chi by Karrueche and ColourPop. Now I'm going to set my face with my NYX Dewy Setting Spray. And I'm going to go and fix my hair, and then I'm going to come back and do some over the top poses. Sometimes I don't want to feel those memories. Yeah, it's like.